Hey, what's up, my spooky family? It's me, Tay Spooky, and I started out so awkward, I'm sorry. I wanted to tell a personal scary story, and it has to do with my grandfather who passed away, I think, 2 years ago, 2 or 3 years ago. The reason I want to tell this story is because something went down with my grandmother, and it was just so wildly ironic and kind of just overall creepy that I just kind of want to tell a story. So he has done a lot since he's passed away, spiritually, paranormal, just like. Before I get started there, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and become a part of the spooky family so that you can send me your scary stories and I can tell your scary stories and I can tell you my scary stories and we can go ghost hunting and do all kinds of fun shit. My grandfather passed away on, I think he passed away on September 3rd. When he died, it was not a sudden thing. It was very long, drug out. It was painful, but people got to say their goodbyes. And it was obviously a very sad experience for the entire family. But what happened was he basically had no blood flow to his leg. Couldn't get surgery to fix it, but had no blood flow. Anyways, so he goes back to the ER because now he's delusional, he's not making sense. And he goes to the ER and he is pale as a ghost by the time everyone got there to see him. It was not looking good at all. He ended up having to get his leg amputated from like right above the knee down. He was not happy about it when he woke up. It was very traumatic. I mean, it would be traumatic for anybody, but it's a very traumatic thing to happen to someone before they go. He had, you know, the family there. And I think it kind of drug out for a week, maybe a little over a week. I'm not entirely sure. My memory is terrible. No one had foreseen death at this point. Like, yeah, it looked bad, but no one was immediately thinking the worst. People were like planning what we're gonna do, when he's gonna go home and stuff like that. And then suddenly, a couple days later, things just turned. And it turned out from the surgery or whatever, got blood clots in his lungs and it just wasn't looking good. Wasn't getting better. He was losing oxygen rapidly. And, you know, they put him on the hospice floor. He was awake for a lot of it. And I think he knew it was coming, but no one really upright told him what was happening. But he also wasn't really all there. Like, he, you could tell, kind of knew what was going on in and out. We were, like, telling him that we loved him and stuff. But he was telling us, like, I want to go home, I want to get out of here. So on top of that, he died somewhere he did not want to die. My grandfather slowly passes away. We were there the last night, a few moments before he actually passed away. We were on our way back home and we're going to come back in the morning. My parents were there with him whenever it happened. So they called us back, we went back. And we saw him, but it was too late, and it was done, and no one, like, expected it to happen that night, but it happened. I just saw a shadow person. When he died, we had a funeral, and his body was, it was an open casket, and then we had a showing, and then he was cremated. So my grandmother got the ashes. The ashes were just bagged in a box. Not yet put in an urn or anything. And when he was at her house, he did a lot of things. He would make extremely cold spots in the hall by his room. They had separate rooms. His room, where it would be extremely cold. You'd get a weird feeling walking by there, and he would knock down pictures in the hallway. I never asked specifically what pictures, that would actually be helpful to know, but he would knock down pictures all the time. And You could hear him. You could see shadows, stuff like that. Overall, just like really, really made my grandmother feel very uncomfortable. I think because it was such a tragic death and it happened where he didn't want to die, his leg was cut off, he was just overall not happy with what was going on. So, unknowing on my side, my dad took his ashes and everything stopped happening at her house. Nothing was happening anymore. Well, that's when things started happening here, and I didn't know they were here yet. Things just started happening, and I was like, what? Did something follow me home? Because like I go paranormal investigating, I do all kinds of stuff. I knew there was an increase in activity, but I didn't know what it was. I knew it was a male energy, but I didn't know what it was. So one day I heard, and I've told this in a previous video, I was brushing my teeth, and I think I even like showed you guys, I went out there and showed you guys what it looked like. I was brushing my teeth and I heard something run up the stairs, like specifically 2 feet, and it was sprinting and stomping. I was home alone and I was brushing my teeth. It happened and I literally, I just blew it off. I was like, huh, it's probably the dog, but it was not the dog. And it ran all the way up the stairs and then down the hallway until it reached basically where the bathroom door would be. And that was like one of the main things. I was like, there's something here. On top of that, I would see a figure of a man, shadow person, just random things. Feelings of being watched, not like evil, not an evil feeling, but just like a weird unhappy feeling. Things started getting less negative, random paranormal things. What would start happening is the restroom, the half bathroom downstairs that he would use when he came over, that light would just turn on and turn off whenever it wanted. No one could be in there, the door could be shut. We would see that happen a lot, not just me, like other people in the family. And even one time I was walking, so the half bathroom is kind of by the front door. It's like in a hall by the front door. And out of the corner of my eye, I saw a shadow person. And I didn't really acknowledge it because I just thought maybe I was seeing something. But immediately when I looked over at the bathroom where I saw the shadow person go, that light came on immediately after, and I was like, ah, okay. We still have the ashes. Things kind of died down here. Things aren't happening as much. But now at my grandmother's house, I went over there and it just did not feel good. It did not feel good in the hallway by his room. I, like, when I was walking away from it, I felt like I had to watch my back. Touch me, you know, like I felt like something was trying to grab me. I don't think he's here. Like I don't know where he is. I don't know if he's here or there anymore. It's died down a lot. The bathroom light will still turn on sometimes, but like I don't know, maybe he goes back and forth, I don't know. But at my house, this is where he would come during holidays and everyone would get together, would be at our house. So you know, this was like a good time. So I think he likes being here, but also he wants to be with my grandma sometimes. But then, one thing that happened that was really weird was on the day he went to the hospital, he was like getting swollen. They take off your jewelry. He took off, she got his wedding ring, so everything went down and he passed away. And then she said ever since then she couldn't find the ring. She did not know where the ring went. And she looked all over his room, all over her room, all over everywhere. Chunk Count was to make an appearance. Oh, you're a chunky girl. Tell him hi. Oh, you're beautiful. 2 years later, like 2 whole years later, she found the wedding ring on the floor in his room, in the middle of the room, just sitting there. It's not like she overlooked it, like, she would clean in there and vacuum in there. Like when she cleaned, she would vacuum. She'd vacuum the floor. She would have vacuumed it up by now. So she found the wedding ring randomly. But the reason I felt compelled to tell the story was because the very ironic, spooky thing that happened was my grandmother needs to get surgery. A pretty, I would consider a hardcore surgery. She happened to be scheduled at the same hospital on the same day that my grandfather passed away. Her surgery was at the same place and same day that my grandfather passed away. And she was like, nope, no, hell no. So she changed the date a couple of weeks later. She's like, I'm not doing it. I don't feel good about that. And I just, everyone thought I was like, just, it was just so crazy. Leave a comment down below if you would have got the date changed too, because so far everyone that I know was like, yes, I would have also rescheduled that shit because that's creepy. I love you guys. Be good, stay safe, and doses.